As Ontario locked down for this pandemic, gig economy workers, particularly food couriers, became busier than ever. David Rockney Corgan is our Ontario Hubs journalist covering the eastern part of the province. He's been looking into what it's helped reveal about this subset of the labor force and joins us now from Kingston. Welcome to the show.
Hi, Jan.
Now, gig workers have precarious employment at the best of times. What has life been for them during this pandemic?
Well, it's been an interesting couple of months. One of the folks I spoke to for this story, Brees Sofer, he's an Uber Eats food courier in Toronto, and he said as soon as the pandemic hit, like many people, everything was shut down. There were deliveries to be made, but he decided not to work. And then as the time progressed, he got back on his bike, and he said in the early days it was, you know, pretty surreal, like going through a post-apocalyptic scene, driving on empty streets and dropping off food at people he would rarely see because people didn't want to make contact, personal contact there. And then he's been back on his bike. He figures he's going about 4 to 5 days a week. As his other employment, his other sources of income have dried up, it's actually become, he's relying on it now, basically, to pay his rent. But some of the changes that they've gone through, Uber, in this particular case, had sent out a policy to its workers, including things like having to wear masks. And in order to prove that they've worn a mask every day before he goes out on his bike, he needs to take a selfie with the Uber app and send it to them to show that he's at least starting his day with a mask. So that's one big way that things have changed for food couriers in Ontario.
I want to talk about how COVID-19 has shed light on some of the broader labor issues and employment issues in the gig economy.
Sure. So one of the folks I spoke to was a regional director for the UFCW, the United Food and Commercial Workers Union, and they are part of a union drive for Uber drivers. And this man, Pablo, tells me that some of the issues, many of the issues that were there before the pandemic are still there, and they've just sort of become exacerbated or highlighted because of the pandemic. So one of those is wages. And, a lot of these drivers are on the road for more than 40 hours a week, we'll say, and often, it'll end up being less than minimum wage that they're paying. So some of these issues, a lot of them have actually just been sort of turned up for these drivers over the last 3 months.
I'm curious, what are the options, for these workers if they feel their rights are violated?
Sure. There's a couple of interesting things happening right here in Eastern Ontario, one of which is the Ottawa Pro Bono Legal Clinic. This is some law students at the U of O offering legal services for people who think that they may have an employment or labor case. But even more interesting is out of Queen's University here in Kingston, we've got the Conflict Analytics Lab, which is using troves of data in order to determine whether somebody may have a labor law case. So if people wanted to go and they think that maybe they're being their rights are being violated or exploited by their employer, that they could go onto this website, myopencourt.org, to see if maybe they've got a case. And then it'll search through data using AI, and then we'll connect these folks with a lawyer if they've got a case.
David, always a pleasure to have you on the show. Of course, our viewers can read your article on tvo.org. It's David Rockney Corgan, our Ontario Hub journalist covering Eastern Ontario. Thanks again.
Thanks, Jan.
The Agenda in the Summer with Naam Kiwanuka is brought to you by the Chartered Professional Accountants of Ontario. CPA Ontario is a regulator, an educator, a thought leader, and an advocate. We protect the public. We advance our profession. We guide our CPAs. We are CPA Ontario. And by viewers like you. Thank you.